inside real quick. It did not take me 5 minutes. Of course, I didn't have two people, but still, like, this thing took me nearly 3 to 4 hours to put together. But welcome back, you guys. You know I'm back. I'm trying to get back into these videos again. This is my vlog, and yeah, to see where we go for the next rest of the year. But I do have some updates, and I do have new things coming up. God, I don't got my mic. I didn't put the mic on.
Yo, I am so out of practice. I don't know how to do this no more. Yeah, there goes right there. Get sound, hopefully.
So yeah, trying to get back into this. I missed this so much. Like, it's been a while. Oh, shoot. Well, my last real video, but it was pretty short, probably like 3 months ago. But, you know, a lot of things have been happening during that time, been crazy busy, and that's why I've been on my video production lately. So I'm just gonna give you guys an update of what I've been up to. So like I mentioned, I've been crazy busy, and, you know, it's for good reasons. One, starting off, got a new addition to the family. We got a little baby boy. So that's really great, and that's really awesome. And yeah, I'm getting used to that whole routine over again, waking up every 2 hours, giving a milky cup, changing the diaper, burping, and repeat. So yeah, that's what I'm doing right now, and that's in the new addition. And I'm super excited because for the longest, I thought it was just gonna be girls in this household. But now we running too deep up in here, okay? Okay? All right, going back to this. All right, now I can see another individual grow up and see him, you know, get impact from me as little, as big as possible. So that's gonna be pretty awesome. And yeah, so the other reason I've been pretty much occupied over the last couple of months is I've been building and buying a house. And you may already know, like, the market's been crazy in certain, like, areas, especially in Austin. So yeah, I just went with the best option that was best fit for us. So I think this is a really big milestone for myself because, you know, I was able to do this for my family and provide them a house. Been pretty crazy the last couple of years, you know, moving from Florida to Austin and stuff like that. And I just found that it was just a reasonable thing to do, to just buy a household and put money into a house that I can, like, officially own, like, sooner or later. And another reason why it was a pretty big milestone for myself is because I was able to go through this whole entire process mostly by myself. And the reason why I say mostly is because at the very beginning of this whole entire home buying process, I got some help from my wife in order to fix, you know, my credit and stuff like that. I was like, it's 750, but then after, you know, we were doing all the stuff that I need to do to take off of my credit report, I essentially got up to, like, you know, very low 800s. So that was really awesome. Yeah, and she also helped me, you know, initially when we were looking for houses and stuff like that. Yeah, like I said previously, the market was crazy, crazy. Like, the reason why I say it was crazy, crazy, because on pre-existing houses, we had seen bids over 150K in certain areas in Austin. So that was ridiculous for pre-existing houses. And I think it was mainly investors and stuff during that time, on account of a lot of things going on. One, tech companies were moving here. Two, lower interest rate. So pretty much put the market on fire for pre-existing houses. And I did get around that. I want to give credit to my homie Keith because he pretty much set me up. He really put the thought in my head on pretty much buying a new construction build. At first, I thought it was going to be like crazy high or something like that, but really it was actually pretty reasonable with what I'm making here now. And yeah, I think it was just a really great way to go because I was able to just put a little bit over the asking price of what they were selling for this house. I essentially went through the whole entire process of filling out the paperwork, pulling out more credit, negotiating rates for my loans and stuff like that. And I got a really decent loan for my particular rates, lowest in a couple of decades. So really happy with what I have, and, you know, I'm gonna have that loan rate for a very long time. Shout out to my homie Keith once again to put me on for that. And yeah, everyone who helped me out during that process, I really appreciate it. I think another thing too, when I was thinking about houses, for the longest I was just gonna rent a house, and maybe because it was like this thought in my head for the longest that I thought a house was a liability, but in actuality it really isn't. And I feel like a lot of people who house houses or got houses just before the increase in prices, increase in market in certain areas, their wealth got exponentially, like, increased during that time. So if you own a house or you got a house just before, like, the market went pretty crazy, you probably got increasing your home value or equity during this time because it's just a really great asset in a sense. And a lot of people think because, yeah, you have to pay a mortgage, yeah, you have to do your own repairs and stuff like that. I looked at it like this. When you're putting down a mortgage, yeah, there's principal and there's interest. And as you pay principal every single month on top of the interest, you pay more principal on it. But then later on, as that principal continues to build up, you build an equity inside that house. And then also there's a rule in regards to like housing. If you stay in that house for 2 years, within the first 5 years, it doesn't have to be consecutive. You can sell that house and any gains during that equity and also the house market going up, appreciation, you can sell that house with tax free. So that's just really awesome. So yeah, now I'm looking at it. All right, there's many ways I can go about with using this house if I don't want to stay in it with my family for like the first year or like 2 years later down the line, I can rent it out. And then if I don't really want it and I don't want to deal with like managing the property, I can sell it after 2 years and get my money back and then some. So, you know, I have a different outlook on how that is now, and that's really awesome. And it was another thing that's going to continue to add to my portfolio of investments. I can literally go on forever about this new found knowledge and how I think about like these real estate and all this other stuff, but I'm going to go into the next thing why I've been pretty occupied during this time, pretty much during this time of having a kid and also getting a house. I was also doing interviews. If you probably follow my Twitter thread, I was going over like thing companies and essentially my process and what I was going through and all this other stuff, my failures and my wins and stuff like that. And yeah, I was just going through that whole entire process. Probably didn't mention every single thing, but for the most part, it was pretty great. So out of like 15 interviews that I had during that time span of like 2.5 months, I got 4 offers. So that's really awesome. And ultimately, I got a chance to actually accept one of the offers. I'm actually starting a new job relatively soon, the next day of this video, but you might probably get this like later on in the week. But yeah, so that's really awesome. New job, new opportunity. And you know, doing it big. With great salary raises come irresponsible spending. Not really, but I kind of did something. So during that time, also after receiving that job, I bought some more lenses, and mainly these lenses were mainly for my business, for YouTube, and also for my other business that I'm going to be doing. You know, I dropped like $1,000 on these lenses, and I think it's gonna be a really good investment for this YouTube channel because I can do a lot of things with these lenses, and I'm going with like a particular look. So I like that fact. And also I'm gonna be taking a lot of photography with these lenses as well. It's not gonna be a photography business, but I'm gonna be taking photography of the assets that I'm gonna be displaying and stuff pretty soon. I might go into that a little bit, but it doesn't really go over into like software in particular. And just to go like in a particular sector of business I'm trying to get into, so it's a transportation business. And so for the most part, I had my business for 3 years since it's a transportation business. At first, for the longest, I put it off on the side, but I was still paying my annual reports and stuff that I need to pay for my LLC. But it was just recently that I came about this particular idea and opportunity, and I want to see how it goes. So just to give you a quick number, so it's like, all right, if I can get 100% return on my money, all right, that's great. If I can get 300% return on my money, that's phenomenal. But I was seeing numbers, doing calculations and doing analysis, 500 to 600%. And I said, yo, I should have started this yesterday. The crazy part of that is that's not even revenue. That's like net profit before taxes. So 500 to 600%, which is freaking crazy. Yeah, I'm gonna be doing that for my transportation business that I've been having for the last 3 years and see how I can get that running where I have to do minimal work in regards to it and just hire some people on and put people on in that particular business. So yeah, before the year is out, I'm definitely gonna be getting started with that business. I'm probably gonna be doing something in regards to it next month to get it going. A lot of new things are coming my way, and I welcome the change because I wanna receive it if I didn't deserve it. So I'm gonna be super grateful for the blessings that continue to come my way and, you know, make things happen. So yeah, until next time, peace out, fam.